music is that from? Well, what if I were to tell you that that was the original music to Halo? What? Well, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. For a while, you know, I like Halo. I love Halo. No, I really do like Halo. I enjoy the gameplay. I like the enemies. I like the design of it. I do. However, I get a little bothered because not a lot of people know its origins. And its origins are in a game called Marathon, which was made in 1995. I was in first grade at the time and wasn't able to really experience it until roughly around the third grade, possibly the fourth. But this game was the Macintosh's answer to Doom. But unlike Doom, it featured the first ever millions of colors, meaning that light, shadow, and mysterious atmospheres could be implemented a lot more than Doom's simple strobing lights, and not to mention, well, anyway. Now, of course, the music that you just heard was actually from Marathon 2 Durandal. Oh, you know, they actually remade it for Xbox Live. That caught me completely off guard. With Freeverse software, and they even redid the sprites, and that was okay, I guess. Some of them looked pretty cool, but I dare say I enjoy the originals. But going back to my original rant, you see, there are a lot of elements in Halo that are directly taken from Marathon. You might even argue that Halo is a continuation of Marathon in the sense that the logo for Marathon is plastered all over Halo. Marathon logo seen here is tattooed on someone's flesh. However, for the sake of presenting a proper homage, I will show it in its original form in this one right here. There it goes, isn't it nice? And here is, of course, Halo. And look, look, look in the center! It's right there! Ah! And of course, who could forget Captain Keyes, who sports the logo right on his fucking chest! There it is! There it is! And if you don't believe me, here's a close-up. And there it is, as you can see, plain as day. Now, there are other examples of the logo in the game. It's on the ship, and I'm sure it's other places as well. But these are the main examples. I don't know if the Halo I don't know if the Marathon logo exists in the other Halos. I haven't played Halo 2 or Halo 3, so whatever. I mean, I have a Macintosh, what can I say? But that's not really what I care about. Here's the thing. Everyone's talking about how Halo has great, great gameplay, but nobody said anything about Marathon. You see, because, you know, all the weapons in Halo, almost all of them, were the ones used in Marathon. It had the shotgun, it had the assault rifle, it had the magnum, it had the charging weapon where you hold it down and it goes... It had the flamethrower even, it had the rocket launcher, and I don't mean it had similar weapons. I mean, they looked almost perfect. I mean, if you saw the comparison, you would realize that they are fucking derived from the same thing. I mean, Jesus Christ! Ugh! And not to mention the fact that you played a biomechanical super cyborg warrior that couldn't be defeated and who had an overshield that, if broken down, would kill you. Not to mention that you could also pick up alien weapons and use them too. That was also in Marathon! But here's where the difference is. Despite all the similarities, despite everything, there's a huge difference, and that is this tone and the story. See, Marathon is actually quite dark. It's literally dark, but also it's genuinely eerie, I thought. When I played it first as a kid, I was genuinely creeped out. And even later, after I learned that I should read everything in the story, it just got much more in-depth. And I have to say that Halo, the storyline, in comparison to Marathon, sucks. Of course, not that anyone who plays Halo plays it for the single player anyway. But still, you know, maybe it's because the story sucked. You see, I like... What's her name? The AI in Halo. I like... Well, the naked chick. I like her. I think she's got a good personality. But he's nothing compared to the original AIs in Marathon, which were Tycho, Durandal, and Leela. And let me tell you, you want to talk about sarcasm, wit, and craziness? You just can't top those AIs. I'm sorry. I loved the storyline. And you had to read it, too. And you know what? You know what? That's not bad. It wasn't a bad thing. Like, at first, you know, because I was like a diehard first-person shooter person. I didn't give a shit about the storyline. And when I first played Marathon, it was like, I have to read? Fuck that shit, you know? But the minute I start reading, they just did such a good job that I was, didn't mind at all. I was totally, totally into it. They did a really fucking good job! Okay, this movie's becoming long. But first of all, for all you real Marathon fans, let me tell you something. I got a jumpsuit, and it's green, and I put the logo right on. Born on board. Frog blast event core. Engineering department on the UESC Marathon. I did it, and nobody gets the reference. So, in other words, this is my message to all you would-be gamers. All you people that pwn the noobs all day. This was a stepping stone in gaming history, whether you're willing to admit it or not. And it is available, the entire trilogy, for free on the internet. It is available for Windows, Linux, and Macintosh. I can play the game whenever I want now. And I love it. Now, all I have to say is that all us obscure Marathon fans are twice as intellectual as any other kind of gamer that I've met. And that's just the way it is. I mean, maybe not the Myst fans. I mean, or Buried in Time, or Obsidian. The Last Express, or The Last Express. I didn't leave it out. I know. The Last Express. Also The Last Express. I mean, I'm smart, but I'm not a genius, fuck. But the fact of the matter is, it is one of the classiest first-person shooters, especially for its time. It was revolutionary, and no one recognizes that. And despite the fact that they have the logo in the original Halo, it's just not enough. And that's what I have to say. So, they're everywhere! So many inside jokes. I'm sorry for the length of this video, and I'm sorry that it was boring, I'm sorry, but I had to say it. And I don't like to normally talk about my gaming experience because it's obscure and not a lot of people agree with it, but what can I say? Just pray that I don't ever make a video on my favorite game. Nobody wants that. Nobody wants that. Bye!